Everyone, this is the Candy Couple. I'm Julia.
And I'm Aaron.
And today we want to talk about how we made it to debt-free living and how you can get there too. But before we get started, we would really appreciate it if you'd hit the like button. So, big goal for us in 2023 was to get 100% debt-free.
And I didn't know if it was possible, in all honesty, because I knew it was going to be a hard push.
This wasn't our goal coming into 2023.
No, it was 2024, 2025, depending how we did a few things. I mean, at minimum, and this was on a 30 or 20?
20, I think.
20-year loan, 20 something? Year,
something like that.
We did in 2 years.
Yep, 2 years. We hit it hard. We hit it very, very hard. And we actually pivoted in the middle of the year to make this happen.
Yeah. This, like I said, wasn't our goal at the beginning. Made changes to make it happen in a year.
Yes, so we've hit it really hard this year, and we are, as of today, this is Tuesday, 100% debt free.
Yes.
Everything has been paid off. We are completely free of any shackles of debt.
Yep.
100%. And how do you feel?
Amazing. And like I said, don't plan on ever going back again. We'll be using sinking funds, other methods. You'll hear us talk about from time to time to keep us from ever going into debt again.
Absolutely. So I feel really good too. I feel like this weight has been sitting on my chest for months. It's been burdening me more than Aaron.
It bothers her more.
It does. But we really amped up, and I feel like we're a really good example of a millennial couple, because this is the big thing right now. Millennials out there saying we can't get ahead. We've had the debt. We've had big debt.
And a lot of it is of trying to be in the hip to the cool things. As you see, everything I'm saying is like 70s or 80s. As you can see, we're definitely not in it.
Not very trendy. But you can do it. You can do it. And I feel like the way society has glassed everything over, debt's considered a good thing.
And our society now is built that everything revolves around debt.
It does. And they don't want you out of it.
No.
We had the hardest time.
Just getting our payoff letter.
Yeah.
To make the final payment was, two or three times.
Four times of contacting them.
Yeah. A couple by phone, a couple by their website, etc.
And they don't want the money. They don't. And then they charge you a fine for paying it off early.
Yes.
But we'll talk about that in a later video. So we want to give you the things that we did, tried and true, work every single time to help you get out of debt. I know it can feel impossible, but you can do it. You just have to work at it.
Yeah.
It doesn't happen overnight. I'm sorry, it doesn't. You have to work at it. So number one, we live below our means.
Yep, big time.
We've lived below our means. But we always have.
We have.
Ever since we got together, we've always lived below our means. We've always looked at our take-home income as not, this is how much we get to spend every single month. It has always been, okay, now how do we keep our margins of what we actually have to spend and what we can save? How can we keep what we save bigger than what we have to spend?
Right.
Always. Because when we first got together, I think it really shaped our financial relationship, as we had three really big things that hit us hard.
Yeah, within a month.
3 months. Yeah, 3 months. It was in a month.
Yeah.
It was in June. Bam, bam, bam. And it just sort of hit us all at once. And they were really, really big costs that we had to cover when we had first gotten together and started living together. So you can live below your means and really make differences. And living below your means is just making some changes. Maybe don't get your hair done every month. Get it done every other month.
Don't get coffee out. Make it at home. Don't order through
DoorDash.
Yes.
Go get it.
Well, don't even go get it, as we'll talk about later.
Well, we don't want anybody to feel like they're deprived. You can go out to eat. We did it.
We do, but now it's not a daily ritual.
It's not a daily ritual. That's the difference. They're treats. They're not daily rituals. It's okay to treat yourself and make that part of your budget, but it cannot be like every day, this is a treat to myself. You could find really inexpensive things that make you feel good and bring you happiness that don't cost a lot of money.
Yeah.
I like fancy coffee. I like a mocha. I like a mocha coffee. I found mixing a little bit of hot chocolate with my coffee and my homemade coffee creamer is pretty darn good. It is really good.
Yeah,
you like it.
I like it.
He likes it. And he's not fond of chocolate and coffee as much as I am. So, and that brings me a little bit of joy. I make it at home and it is nothing compared to what I would pay out.
Right.
We lived and breathed by our budget.
Everything revolves around our budget.
Everything.
Because that tells us how much we have to eat out, for example, for the month. How much gas money we have for the month. How much we try to keep the energy bill below. You know, stuff like this that we are constantly watching, making small lifestyle changes to make sure that we stay in this realm or below this realm.
I would say the biggest change we made probably this year has been in energy usage. It was an area we really didn't feel we had any control over because we couldn't see the numbers. Yes. Once we were able to see those numbers, you can make some significant changes. You really can if you monitor. I will also say the other thing that we have done is we've not looked at the budget once a month. We've not looked at it every other month. We have looked at it every week. At least every week.
Yeah.
And the longest we would go was two.
Yeah, and I'm probably looking at it more bi-daily or something compared to when she'll look at it, you know, weekly.
Yeah, so we would actually look at it, talk about it, make sure we're on the same page. And this also goes with neither one of us ever spend a dollar without the other person knowing about it.
Correct.
A dollar, a cent. We do not make purchases without the other person knowing. We just don't do it.
Yep. Talk about it.
Every dollar.
It's how you stay on budget.
How you stay on budget. How you stay in tune with your spouse. And I know a lot of couples would not like that. They would feel like they're shackled to this budget. If you need a discretionary fund, that's fine. But the majority of your purchasing should be done together. Aaron knows exactly what I want at the grocery store.
Yeah.
And he doesn't like it. And this isn't like, well, no, you can't have this. There's none of that. It's more of a, okay, that's what you think we need. He knows I will stick to that budget as much as I can. And if I think I'm going to go over, like, listen, we've got a lot of stockpile items that are on a really good price. I will go over our weekly grocery budget this week. I'll make up for it later, but I'm going to hit it hard this week because there's so much on sale and I need to stock up. He's like, okay, you know what you're doing. He lets me own my realm, but we talk about it. Before we go, when we come home, to make sure we feel like we're on the same page. That keeps us on the same page with budgeting and with our money. We realize that the little things really do add up. This is becoming a big trend. It really is. Of like listing like what you spend in a week. And then saying, oh, you could save $25 if you make coffee at home. But a lot of these I'm seeing DoorDash, Uber, all of these other costs. And I'm like, I see like half your budget I could cut off of here.
Yeah.
Like half. And yeah, your coffee is $25 a week, 4 weeks in a month. That's $100. $100 times 12 months.
$1,200.
That might look like peanuts to a lot of people.
That's a lot of money.
That's a lot of money. That's a lot of money. If you're doing the average monthly grocery budget, which for a family of four is $1,200. That's not our number. That is the government number that's out there in the middle of nowhere. You saw Aaron's face. He was like, oh my God. If you go by that number, that's 1 month of groceries that you've spent on coffee for your family of four. 1 month of groceries. Now, that's like 4 months of groceries in our house or more. Because that's a lot of money. That is a lot of money. And it's just really getting some perspective that, no, you're not going to see it immediately, but you're going to start making a lot of little changes. You're not going to have extra fees if you go out to eat by getting DoorDash and Uber Eats. You're going to go pick up your food yourself. It's this world of convenience.
Which
you're getting charged for.
Yes, you need to get back to the basics.
Peel your own vegetables. They're cheaper. Wash them, peel them, cut them. Yep. It doesn't take that much time. Peel your own vegetables. That will save you some extra cost if you buy them whole in their most natural form, because you're paying for the convenience of somebody else to peel them, cut them, slice them, and clean them for you. So do all of that. You're paying for convenience. And if you start cutting out some of these convenient items, some of these convenient things, you'll start to see some savings. And they will add up. It's dollars add up very fast. So fast. And we know when we're on point, we're not doing silly things with our money. We're not making silly purchases. We will see those dollars add up very quickly.
Correct.
Very quickly. It could be the tune of $1,000 a month. I mean, if you really look at it, of how much you're charged fees, how often are you eating out? How often are you getting food? How often are you doing these things? When, okay, you're busy. It doesn't take that much time to put a pot of pasta on the stove and add spaghetti sauce to it. That's a $2 meal. It is. I can get pasta sauce for 88 cents and a box of pasta for 89. That's a $2 meal. It's all you need. And your kiddos will be thrilled. So those dollars really add up. We look at every single way to cut costs. This has been Aaron.
This is me, mostly, from apps to reward credit cards to cash back type things. Anything that we can come up with like that to save money, we make sure to take advantage of.
Absolutely. He's really diligent about getting those receipts in the apps, everything. And he doesn't just like use one.
I use a few. Like 6 or 7 different ones. But, you know, just cashed out on a $5 Amazon gift card yesterday. I'll cash out on another one tonight. Hey, you know.
And it took you how much time? Maybe 5 minutes?
5 minutes or so just to scan some receipts in.
And he just makes it part of his routine. So he gets it done. And before, even when we first started, I guess it kind of felt like a little bit of a chore when they first started coming out. Mm-hmm. But now that they've gotten better and easier to use, I feel like you've...
Yeah. It's something I'm constantly making sure that we're on top of. And, you know, rewards credit cards, I know we talk about that a lot, but, you know, we do them responsibly. We do not carry balances, because those 20, 30% balance...
Interest
rates would kill you. You have to be able to pay off whatever you put on it.
Absolutely. We cut back on services. This is another thing Aaron was very diligent on.
Hey, we didn't need a couple streaming services. One at a time is enough. We can watch through it and then switch to another if we want to, or just cut it back. There's no need to keep a couple anymore. And the way they keep increasing their prices, you can't afford to do more than one anyways.
In around Black Friday is a great time. If you're looking for them, you can really get a good price.
Hulu and Disney Plus ran a special, $2.99 for 12 months.
And then you had, I think, Paramount Plus ran one, Peacock ran one.
For 3 months for those.
So everybody had something that they were running. As a special. I know Hulu, you used to be able to get it for $1 a month, 99 cents.
That's what it was. It was 99 cents this time still. Plus, you had the $2 for Disney Plus.
Yeah, so, you could really search for those good deals and go with it that route versus trying to have them all. And we're even still looking to cut back more this year as they come due. So, we're looking at, do we really need it? Do we really want it? Can we cut that back and
not
have that extra?
Not if it's above $2.99.
Can we cut it back? And we're also trying to make sure we're using the ones that we do pay for. We do still have Philo, but we are using it. We do use it quite a bit.
We do use it quite
and
a bit.
And we were grandfathered in at the much cheaper price than what it is today.
If we came back now and subscribed for it, we wouldn't probably have
it.
Or... we wouldn't have Hulu and Disney Plus probably on the side, just because from the price perspective.
No, there's just no way. So we really cut back on services. We're really careful with our food budget here as well. We've been very careful with every area of our budget. But I would say food has been one where...
you can make the most impact.
You can make the most impact fast. You can make a really good impact fast if you know how to build a working pantry, how to use your working pantry. I typically don't buy food from the grocery store to cook with unless it's like a lot on sale that I can make something that we don't have very often. I typically cook from my pantry, my freezers, and use the cells, what few cells we get anymore, and stock up.
And we eat leftovers.
We eat a lot of leftovers. Leftovers are a really big thing. Meal planning, meal prepping has been a huge thing for us. Mm-hmm. It saves me time, effort, and energy.
And money.
But my effort and energy is money, too. I don't think I could have made it through this year without meal planning. Mm. I would have quit. We would have been eating out more because I'm so exhausted by the end of the day that to think I have to cook a meal, I have to do everything that I need to do, I wouldn't have gotten it done. So we just really, really focused on that meal planning. And I would say having the little containers has helped us so much. I can go through, have it out for a week, and we're one and done, and it just helps so much. It helps with the perspective of me having to set it out during the day, having to clean. It's just saved us so much money. It has saved me so much time. As a busy mom, I can't even tell you how much time it's saved. What would you say? Would you agree with that?
Oh, yeah, definitely.
And the next one is we still lived. We still went out.
We still did things. We just had it as part of our budget built into it.
So you can go out to eat. You can have your coffee once a week.
Don't go over this specific number in your budget.
You have $25 a month for coffee or $25 a week for coffee. Whatever that number is, you decide. Whatever that number is. Don't go over that. It's what you have.
Yep.
Every single month. For us, eating out, doing some fun things every once in a while, that's built into our budget. And we always try to stay below it. Like, how can we get the best deal possible? What can we do to cut our costs even more and still live the life we want to live? You can do it. You absolutely can. And then this last one.
You don't need to keep up with the Joneses. I mean, you don't need every new thing, every new trend. You don't need it.
They're called trends for a reason.
Because we're built on a consumer society to buy stuff. Okay. Do you need it? No, you don't. You just need what you need to make your life comfortable and the way you want it to be.
Yes. Now, a lot of people say, well, for my life to be comfortable, I have to be following the trends.
No.
I would say reevaluate your life. Reevaluate your life. Reevaluate a little bit. If it's going to help make your life better, I could see investing in yourself. But for me, having a really, really fancy purse is not an investment in myself or our family.
No.
Absolutely not. Having really, really fancy sunglasses is not an investment in our family. And that's kind of how we look at this. We look at it more, if we're going to spend a lot of money on something that seems to be trending at the moment, how's this going to help us now and in the future? We prefer to do things the old way. How did they do it back then?
Right.
How did they do it without electricity? Because we might not have electricity. We might need to do this where there's not electricity. We try to look at things in that perspective and then look about making the investment in our homestead, in our life, in our every single day. And in our family. Yeah. So we don't really look at what the Joneses are doing. Most people look at us and they're like, these people are nuts. But our every single day we go through, we do the job, we get it done, and we come home, we're happy.
Yeah.
I feel like we're happier for it because we don't have as much stuff to deal with.
Well, any comments, questions that you want to send to us? You know, you can either leave them below in the comments or send it to thekennycouple@yahoo.com. Make sure to go over and check out our link tree, which we're going to be working on a lot of short content, especially like on TikTok. So make sure to go over and check that out.
And be sure to subscribe if you aren't already. We would really appreciate it. And as always, thank you for joining us on The Candy Couple, where we work hard, live simple, and enjoy life. Have a wonderful day.